Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I,
Keshwani. In this video, we'll continue doing the multiplication and division of fractions that we started in the previous video. In the previous video, we did the first 10 problem, 1 through 10, and right now we're going to pick it up from number 11. And we're going to do from number 11 through number 20, the next 10. Here we go. First question is, what is the product of 3 7/9 and 3/4? What's the product of 3 7/9 and 3/4? Well, 3 7/9 can be written as 3 times 9, 3 9s are 27, 27 plus 7, 27 plus 3 is 30, and 30 plus 4 is 34. So it's 34 9 and 3/4. Now all we have to do is simplify it. All we have to do is simplify and see what we get at the end. So we see 3 at the top, we see 9 at the bottom, let's divide top and bottom by 3. 9 is going to go away, becomes 3. We see 4 at the top, we see 4 at the bottom, let's divide top and bottom by 2. It becomes 2, and this 3 has 1, 2. 3 has 1, 2. Let's start again. 3 has 1, 2. 3 has 1, 2. After we take away the 2 from the 3, the remaining one goes and joins the 4 and becomes 14, and 14 has 7 2s. Is there anything else we can do? The answer is no. That's all we can do. 17 is a prime number. 2 is a prime number. 3 is a prime number. Not much is going to happen. That's it. 17 over 6. Of course, we can't leave it like this. 17 over 2, we can't leave it like this. 17 is more than 6. This is an improper fraction. So we'll have to write it as a mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is, of course, is just this 17 over 6 is basically 12 over 6 plus 5 over 6. It is 12, 6 and 5, 6, which is 12 over 6 is 2, and the answer is 2 and 5, 6. 2 and 5, 6. That's it. That's our answer. 2 and 5, 6. Let's go to number 12. Now, if you like, I have not tried it ahead of time, so we're going to try it right now. If you like, we can multiply this thing in a little bit different way. I shouldn't have taken up all this room. Let's erase all those, this thing. This is the traditional method. As you can see, this is a very traditional method. There is nothing unique, nothing novel, nothing exciting about it. Let's do something different. Let's say this is a traditional method. Let's do it a little bit different now. So we're going to multiply these two quantities, and it's very simple. 3 quarters times 3 is just 9/4. And 3 quarters times 7/9, this is going to be 3 quarters times 7/9. This is what we're looking at. 3 is going to cancel away, and we're going to end up with 12 here. To make this thing into 12, we have to multiply top and bottom by 12. We end up with 27 over 12 plus 27 over 12,
of course, is
simply 24 over 12 plus 3 over 12. I hope you're able to see this. This is this part, and then we have plus, then we have this part, 7 over 12. This is just 2, and this is 3 plus 7 is 10. 10 over 12 is what we get. 10 over 12, 2 and 10/12, which of course is the same thing as what we got before, because 10/12 is going to reduce to 5/6. Do you see that? Let's do number 11. Let's do number 12 rather. Number 12. Number 12 simply says, simplify the following problem. 7/4 divided by 5/12. Simplify. When they tell you to simplify, it simply means to find the answer of this problem, which we know what to do. It's going to be 7/4. We take the first fraction, and the division sign is going to become multiplication sign. And 5/12, we are at the reciprocal of it, which becomes 12/5. We see 4 at the bottom, we see 12 at the top. Let's divide top and bottom by 4. It becomes 3, and that's all we can do. All of these 3 are prime numbers. 7 3s are 21. So it's 21 over 5, which is simply 20 over 5 plus 1 over 5. So the answer is 4 and 1 fifth. 4 and 1 fifth, because this is 4 and 1 fifth. Let's do 13. Number 13. Number 13 is asking us to find out the value of 7 plus 3 fifths times 10 39. Now listen very carefully, okay? Since we know our order of operation, I believe something, if you're not very good with order of operations, watch the videos in this series, Basic Math. I don't know which day it is, but in that series, we learn our order of operation, which tells us that we do multiplication before we do the addition or subtraction. This is the order of operation. PEMDAS is the mnemonic people use. The mnemonic that people use, the memory device, is this thing. PEMDAS, P-E-M-D-A-S, PEMDAS. Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. And if you're not familiar with what I just said, don't worry about it, as long as you know the other operation. And therefore we know that we must do our multiplication first before we do our addition or subtraction. So we have to do the multiplication first, right here. So let's take care of this part first, right here. Or we can do it right here. Divide top and bottom by 5, 10 is going to become 2. And divide top and bottom by 3, 3 is going to go away, and 39 is going to become 13, and it's 2 13s. That's it, that's our answer. The answer is 7. 7 just comes there, and it's just 2 13th. That's all it was. Number 14. Number 14 is asking us to find out the value of 5 minus 7 8 divided by 3 quarter. Again, this parenthesis is something that we introduced. What I'm trying to make you understand is that even if this parenthesis wasn't there, we still would have done the same thing. Same thing here. There is no parenthesis, but we know that we have to do our division before we go and do our addition. So we have to do the division. Do you understand? I put the parenthesis in there just for us, for our visual aid, because it's easier to see now. This is something we introduced. It wasn't in the problem. Do you understand? But we don't need parenthesis here. This is something we introduced because it's easy to see. So now again, we're going to do this one first. 7, 8. Division is going to become multiplication, and 3 quarter is going to become 4 third. We take the reciprocal of it. We see 4 at the top. We see 8 at the bottom. Let's divide top and bottom by 4. 8 is going to become 2. And what we end up here is 7 times 1, which is just 7, and 2 times 3 is going to give us 6, which is same as 1 and 1/6. And now we can do our problem. We already know the answer to this problem. This quantity is equal to 1 and 1/6. So watch what happens. I need the room. So this thing boils down to 5 minus 1 and 1/6. This is where you have to pay attention. Do you understand? We cannot simply 5 minus 1 is 4. That's very easy. But how are we going to subtract a sixth? How many sixths does this guy have? This guy, I'm going to write it in red ink so you can see it. This guy has 0 sixths. This guy has 0 sixths. We can't subtract the sixth from 0 sixths. So what we have to do is, we're going to write this guy 5 and 0 sixths. We're going to write that as 4 and 6 sixths. Would you agree that 4 and 6 sixths is 5? Of course, 4 and 6 sixths, because 6 sixths is 1. 4 plus 1 is 5. So now we have written down 5 as 4 and 6 sixths minus 1 and 1 sixth. Now we can do our job. 4 minus 1 is 3, and 6 sixths minus a sixth is going to be 5 sixths. There you go. Do you understand? If you want to do it differently, go ahead and do it differently if you want to. If you want to carry through the entire thing, you can do that, but this is a quicker way. Number 15. Essentially, what we're doing is exactly what we do when we're doing this a subtraction. For example, if I ask you to subtract, if I ask you to subtract 9 from 14, you can subtract. This wasn't a good example. Let's turn this into a 3. Let's turn this into a 3. If you have to subtract 9 from 34, you can't subtract 9 from the 4. So what do? We borrow 1 from the 3. 3 becomes 2 and this becomes 14. This is exactly what we're going on here. Since we cannot subtract a 6th, since we cannot subtract a 6th from a 0, 6, we borrow 1 from this guy. When we borrow 1 from this guy, 5 becomes 4 and the 0, 6 becomes 6, 6. And now we can do our job. Same logic, you understand? What number did you just do? Number 15 is what we're going to do. Next question is, what is the quotient of 3/5? I'm going to erase this thing, we need the room. What is the quotient of 3/5 divided by 18? Let's talk about this. I'm going to erase this thing in a second. This is how the problem is going to be phrased in the exam. This is how the problem is going to be phrased in the exam. And you have to understand, the language. By the way, when did we learn the word mnemonic? You see the word mnemonic here. Mnemonic has a silent M in it. A mnemonic has a silent M in the beginning. When did we learn the word mnemonic in our vocabulary lessons? I'll tell you exactly when. On day number 90. Vocab. Day 90. If you're interested in improving your vocabulary, just type in vocabulary words, day 90, and learn the word. This is how the word question is going to be phrased, and you have to be able to understand the language. You have to be able to understand the jargon, the technical terms that they use, even though this is not so technical. What does it mean, quotient? When they tell you what is the quotient of this divided by that, what are they asking? What they're asking here is, in the language of mathematics, what this means is that what is the result when 3/5 is divided by 18. This is what it is. Quotient simply means the result of division. Quotient means result, right here, result of division. Quotient is just a very fancy way of saying what is the result of division. When you do this division, what is the result of the division? For example, if you were asked to divide, let's say, 17 by 7, if you were asked to divide 17 by 7, 17 has how many 7s? 17 has 2 7s. We get 14 and we get a 3. Which one of these numbers is quotient? The answer is, quotient is the result of our division. This is not the result. This is the remainder. This is not the result. This is just what remains at the end. This is simply what remains at the end. That's just the remainder. This is the result. This is our quotient. This is our quotient. Do you understand? So what is the quotient? What is the result when you divide this number by that number? They are essentially asking you to divide this number by that number. That's all it is. So let's do it. It's just a very fancy way, a very annoying way of saying divide 3/5 by 18. And we know that 18 can be viewed, 18 can be looked upon as 18 over 1. I'm going to write it in a different color so that we can tell that this is something we introduced. It's not in the problem. We introduced this thing just for our visual aid. You understand? In the event that you cannot understand what I'm saying here, I'm going to write it down here for our visual aid. It makes it easier for us to see. Just for our visual aid, we put it in here. So that's it. So it's 3/5. Division is going to become multiplication, and 18 over 1 is going to become 1 over 18, and that's all. We are done. Divide top and bottom by 3. 3 is going to go away. 18 is going to become 6 because 18 has 3 6. 3 6 are 18. Now we get 5 times 6, which is 30. The final answer is 1/30. The final answer is 1/30. Let's do one more. Same exact language. What is the quotient of 3 3/4 divided by 5/8?
3 and 3 quarter divided by 5, 8. Number 16 is this is. Erase all of this thing now, we don't need it. It's going to be too crowded, too confusing. What is the quotient of 3 and 3 quarter divided by 5, 6? So essentially they are asking us to divide 3 and 3 quarter by, not 5, 6, rather 5, 8. 3 fours are 12, 12 plus 3 is 15, so this thing is 15 quarters. 15 quarters make 3 and 3 quarters. Of course, that makes sense because 3 is made up of how many quarters? 3 is made up of 12 quarters. If I have 4 quarters, that's the whole. Think in terms of money. 4 quarters makes a dollar. 8 quarters will make $2. 12 quarters make 3. So 3 is made up of 12 quarters and then we have 3 more quarters, which is why it's 15 quarters. Division is going to become multiplication and 5 8 is going to become 8 fifths. We have an 8 at the top, we have 4 at the bottom. Let's divide top and bottom by 4. Let's divide top and bottom by 4. 4 is going to go away and 8 is going to become 2. We see 5 at the bottom, we see 15 at the top. Let's divide top and bottom by 5 and it's going to become 3. So the final answer is 3 times 2. Answer is 6. Answer is 6. That's all. Number 17. Number 17. 17, 18, 19, and 20. 4 more to go. Number 17. Number 17 says, number 7 is a straightforward question. Straightforward division question. There are no words in it. It says 25 divided by 48. That fraction divided by 5 over 12. Nothing to it. Straightforward question. Let's do it very quickly. So 25 over 48, division is going to become multiplication, and 5 12 is going to become 12 fifth. 12 fifth. I'm not going to do the baby step, dividing top and bottom by 2 or 4. Let's just divide by 12. I hope you're able to see that 4 12s are 48. If you take a 12 and double it, you get 24, and if you double 20, 24, you get 48, which means 48 is made up of 4 12s. Let's divide top and bottom by 12. 48 is going to become 4. Let's divide top and bottom by 5, and that's it. The answer is 5 fourths. 5 fourths is the answer, which we cannot leave it like this because 5 is, happens to be more than 4, so we have to write this in mixed fractions. So it's going to be 1 and 1 quarter. 1 and 1 quarter. Let's do next one. Number 18. Number 18. I want you to pause the video for the next three problems, 18, 19, and 20. Listen carefully. 18, 19, and 20. For the next three problems, I want you to pause the video, do the problem yourself. Don't be lazy. Pause the video, do the problems, and then compare your work against the work that you and I will do together. Do you understand? Here's number 18. As soon as I write it on the blackboard, pause the video. 72 divided by 91 divided by 132 over 105. Times 55 over 54. Do what you have to do. I'll give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Okay, here we go. And I'm going to give you one more chance in the event that you did not get the right answer. The right answer is 25 over 39. 25 over 39. If this is not the answer you got, if this is not what you got, then pause it one more time and give it a second try. Let's begin, shall we? So we have 72 over 91. Division is going to become multiplication. Division is going to become multiplication. We have to reverse this thing. Write the reciprocal of it. 105 over 132 times 55 over 54. That's it. That's it. We're done. Now, all we have to do is simplify it. Because I need the room, because I need the room on the top, I didn't realize, I didn't have the forethought. I should have written a little bit lower, but since I ended up writing it here, and because I need the room, I'm going to erase the actual problem so that we have the room to do our work. Okay, here we go. It's all gone. Let's begin. Now listen very carefully, okay? In which step, in what, which order you go is entirely arbitrary. It's entirely arbitrary. One person might take a different route than the other person, or the same person might take two different routes depending on when the personal problem is given. If you give me the same exact problem right now, I might do it in different order. 10 minutes later, same exact problem, or the same problem tomorrow, I might go in different order. The order does not matter. It's all arbitrary. Do you understand? Whatever clicks, whatever you happen to see. So whatever I'm going to see is what I'm going to do, okay? So is there anything that you see here? I see a 55, but there is nothing here that's a multiple of 5. Oh, I see 132 and 72. Why don't we divide top and bottom by 2? Let's see what happens, okay? Let's see what happens. How many 2's does 7 have? 7 has 3 2's. 7 has 3 2's. The remaining 3 2's are 6. After we take away 6 from the 7, we have a remainder of 1. 1 goes and joins the 2, becomes 12, and 12 has 6 2's. Since we divided top by 2, we have to divide the bottom by 2. How many 2's does 1 have? How many 2's does 1 have? 1 has no 2's. 1 has no 2's. The poor 1 has no 2's. So what does he do? He goes and joins his neighbor. He joins his neighbor and becomes 13. And 13 have 6 2's. 6 2's are 12. After we take away 12 from the 13, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 2, becomes 12. And 12 has 6 2's again. 1. That makes life easy. Oh, there we go, 66 and 55. Now we are talking. Let's divide top and bottom by 11. We divide 55 by 11, it's going to become 5, and 66 is going to become 6. Do you see anything else? Oh, I see 36 and a 6. Let's divide top and bottom by 6. 6 is going to go away, and 36 is going to become 6. Oh, now we are making progress. What else do you see? Do you see anything else? You should see something. Again, I'm going to remind you one more time. For these kind of problems, and I'm going to write it on the top here so that we can use it for the next two problems as well, these are called divisibility rules. Rules of divisibility they are called. And if you do not know these rules of divisibility, basic math, day 25. Watch that video in the basic math series. Basic math, day 25. Watch that video in this series, basic math. Day 25, I believe it is. It might be day 24. I'm just going by my memory here. Or it might be day 26, but in that neighborhood. Watch that video. Make sure you understand the divisibility rule. What we learned in that video, in the divisibility rule, is how to recognize if a given number is divisible by 3. We learned there, in that video, we learned that if the sum of the digits, S-U-M, sum of a digit of a given number, is divisible by 3, the number itself must be divisible by 3. For example, here I see 54. Are you able to see that that's a 54? 5 plus 4 is 9. 5 plus 4, since the sum of the digit is 9, and since 9 is divisible by 3, that tells me that 54 is divisible by 3. I'm going to divide 54 by 3, and I'm going to still divide 6 by 3. Let's do it, shall we? Let's do it. Okay, it's just a matter of paying attention. Concentrate, otherwise you're going to muck it up. You understand? Otherwise you're going to muck it up. Muck it up with an M, as in Mary, not an F. How many 3's does 5 have? 5 has 1 3. 5 has 1 3. After we take away 3 from the 5, listen very carefully. After we take away the 3 from the 5, you have a remainder of 2. What happens to that 2? That 2 goes and joins the 4 and becomes 24. That 2 goes and joins the 4 and becomes 24. And how many 4's does 24 have? 24 has 6. 24 has 8 3's. 8 3's are 24. 8 3's are 24. You see, this is what we did. We're dividing 54 by 3. And what we're asking is, how many 3's does 5 have? Let's do it again if you like. Let's do it again. Watch what happens. How many 3's does 5 have? 5 has 1 3. 5 has 1 3. 5 has 1 3. 5 has 1 3. After we take away the 3 from the 5, we have a remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins the 4 and becomes 24. That 2 goes and joins the 4 and becomes 24. And how many 3's does 24 have? 24 has 8 3's. So we cross out the 4 and put down the 8. 24 has 8 3's. It's a long division that we're doing, but we're doing it in our head. to save time. Do you understand? It's the long division that we're doing, but we're not going to show it like a baby because we're not in fifth grade. So that's enough of that. So we divided this thing by 3. Don't forget, if we just finished dividing 54 by 3, we must divide something on the top by 3. This is also divisible by 3. You see, I just noticed it. 1 plus 5 is 6. 105. Sum of 1 plus 0 plus 5 is 6. This number is also divisible by 3. Let's divide this one 3 to make it more interesting. You can see this is divisible by 3. But let's just divide this by 3. How many 3's does 1 have? How many 3's does 1 have? 1 has no 3. 1 has no 3. That one goes and joins the 0 and becomes 10. How many 3's does 10 have? 10 has 3 3. 3 3's are 9. 3 3's are 9. After we take away 9 from the 10, we have a remainder of 1. That one goes and joins the 5 and becomes 15. And how many 3's does 15 have? 15 has 5 3's. That's it, we're done. We can go one more round. This is 18 and this is 6. Let's go one more round of 3. 18 has 6 3's. And 6 says, actually, we can do 16, 6, divide top and bottom by 6, not by 3. If you divide top and bottom by 6, 6 is going to go away and 18 becomes 3. 18 becomes 3. But see what we are looking at here, it doesn't look like that, does it? So we have to do something. There is a 35. And there is 91. 91 is 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is 10. 91 is not divisible by 3. Is it divisible by 5? Obviously not. It doesn't end in a 5 or a 0. Notice I'm only checking the odd numbers. We're not going to check for the even number, obviously. 91 is not going to be divisible by an even number. You only have to check for the odd numbers. So let's start. Is 91 divisible by 3? The answer is no. We just checked it. 9 plus 1 is 10, and 10 is not divisible by 3. Obviously, it is not divisible by 5. Let's check for the 7, shall we? Let's see if 91 is divisible by 7, because I know 35 is a multiple of 7. Let's check, shall we? How many 7 does 9 have? 9 has 1 7. 9 has 1 7. After we take away 7 from the 9, we have a remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins the 1. It becomes 21. And 21, what do you know? 21 has 3 7's. Since we divided the bottom by 7, we must divide the top by 7. 35 becomes 5. Voila! That's it. That's the end of our story. Everything else is gone. And what we're left with, I'm going to put it in a different color here so you can see it. What we're left with is 5 times 5, giving us a top of 25. And at the bottom we have 13 times 3, giving us a bottom of 39. The answer is 25 over 39. Let's do one more, shall we? What number was this one? Oh, this one was 72. This was number 18. We have two more to go. Number 19. Same exact thing for number 19. As soon as I put the problem on the blackboard, pause the video and do it yourself. I'm going to leave it there for you to remember to watch day number 25 if you want to learn how to recognize if a given number is a multiple of some other number, 1 through 10 that is. Here we go. Number 19, the penultimate question. Number 19, the penultimate question. 21 over 165 divided by 51 over 143 times 87 over 91. Do it yourself. I'll give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Here we go. So we have 21 over 165. The digits have to line up, otherwise it's not going to look pretty. Division is going to become multiplication, and 143 is going to end up on the top. 143 over 51 times 87 over 91. I'm going to erase this part because we need the room to do our work. That's it. That is the problem. We have it here. We're going to erase it. This is the penultimate problem. We learned this word in our vocabulary lessons on day number 11. Again, Just type in vocabulary words, day 11, learn the word penultimate, as we have learned several on several different occasions. It's just a very fancy way of saying second to the last. We are at the second to the last problem, because we're going to do 20 problems and we are at number 19, which makes number 19 the penultimate problem. Let's begin then. Do you see anything at all? I don't see any multiple of 5. This is a multiple of 3. Oh, that's the multiple of 3. 5 plus 1 is 6. 21 is a multiple of 3. Let's begin with 3. You have to start someplace. Don't just stare at it and just sit there. You have to start somewhere. Start anywhere. It doesn't matter. Start anywhere you like. So, 21 has 7 threes. How many threes does 5 have? 5 has 1 3. 5 has 1 3. The remaining, after we take away 3 from the 5, we have a remainder of 2. 2 goes, it joins the 1, becomes 21, and 21 has 7 threes. Oh, actually, I have not told you what the answer of this question is. The answer to this question is, in the event that you are interested, if you did the problem yourself, and if you get this answer, 29 over 85, 29 over 85, then you're okay. If you have an answer something other than this, then pause the video right now and try it one more time. The correct answer is 29 over 85. Let's begin. What else do you see? I see a 6 here and I see 1 plus 5. 1 plus 5 is 6 and this is a 6. This means this number is divisible by 3. And I see 87. 8 plus 7 is 15. Would this work? This would not work. This is 5 plus 3. 8 plus 7 is 15 and 15 is divisible by 3. Sum of the digits of 87 is divisible by 3. Therefore, 87 must be divisible by 3. And this is sum of the digits here are divisible by 3. This number must be divisible by 3. Let's divide by 3 one more time, shall we? How many 3's does 1 have? 1 has no 3's. That one goes and joins the 6 and becomes 16. 16 has 5 threes. 5 threes are 15. After we take away 15 from 16, we have a remainder of 1. That one goes and joins the 5 and becomes 15 again. And 15 has 5 threes one more time. Let's divide the top by 3. How many 3's does 8 have? 8 has 2 3's. 2 3's are 6. After we take away 6 from the 8, we have a remainder of 2. 2 goes and joins the 7 and becomes 27. And 27 has 9 threes. Voila. Oh, so we got the 29 on the top. That's a good sign. Now what else can we do? I see 55. 55 is a multiple of 11. Because 55 is made up of 5 and 11. And since there is nothing here that's a multiple of 5, then one of these three numbers must be a multiple of 11. Makes sense, doesn't it? I'm going to say it one more time. Since we know that 55 is 5 times 11, and there are no numbers on the top that's a multiple of 5, then one of these three numbers must be a multiple of 11. And it's not 29 or 7, which means this must be a multiple of 11. Let's divide this number by 11, shall we? How many 11 does 14 have? 14 has 1 11. 14 has 1 11. After we take away 11 from the 14, we have a remainder of 3. That 3 goes and joins this 3, becomes 33, and 33 has 3 11s. And 55 is going to become 5. Voila. See, I shouldn't have written down number on the answer on the top because I keep staring at it. Because now my goal is to make this thing into that. That's not the right way to do it. Let's carry on. What else can we see here? Because I keep staring at the damn thing here. I can't take my eyes off it. I see a 7 here. Not that it's going to make any difference because I already remember the answer, but still, it's distracting me. I see a 7 here. 5 is not a multiple of 7. 17 is not a multiple of 7. Let's try dividing 91 by 7, see what happens. How many 7's does 9 have? 9 has 1 7. 9 has 1 7. After we take away 7 from the 9, we have a remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins the 1 and becomes 21. And 21 has 3 7's. Since we divided the bottom by 7, we have to divide top by 7. Let's get rid of this 7. And this 13 is going to go away with that 13. That's it. We are done. 29 over 5 times 17. 29 over 5 times 17 is exactly what we said the answer was going to be, because 5 times 17 is 85. Do you understand? That's all. Let's do the last one. Number 20. Again, as soon as I put the problem on the blackboard, pause the video.
last one. 34 over 58 divided by 91 over 143 times 87 over 11 divided by 51 over 14.
Pause the video and do it yourself. I'll give you 5 seconds to do just that for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Alright, I'm going to give you the answer now, and if you do not have the same answer, if you have something other than that, then try it again.
The answer to this problem is 2.
This entire quantity equals 2. If you did not get 2, do it again. Let's begin, shall we? Pause the video and do it again. Answer is 2. 34 over 58. Division is going to become multiplication. We have 143 on the top over 91 times 87 over 11 times, and division is going to become multiplication, times 14 over 51. Pay attention. Make sure you remember to write the reciprocal of it. 51 over 14 becomes 14 over 51, and this becomes 143 over 91. That's it. Again, we need the room, so I'm going to erase this part. We no longer need it. Let's begin. Again, in what sequence we go is completely arbitrary. Do you understand? Whatever you happen to see here, do you happen to see anything at all? Oh, I see a 14. That's a multiple of 7, and we know 91 is the multiple of 7. Let's divide top and bottom by 7. We divide 14 by 7, and we get a 2. 9 has 1 7. 9 has 1 7. The remaining 2 goes and joins the 1, becomes 21, and 21 has 3 7s. I see 13, but there is no 169 on the top. That's a shame, because we know 13 squared is 169. Let's get going, okay? We're taking too long. Let's divide top and bottom by 2, see what happens. 3 has 1 2, the remaining one goes, it joins the 4, it becomes 14. 14 has 7 2s. 5 has 2 2s, 2 2s are 4. After we take away 4 from the 5, 1 goes and joins the 8, becomes 18, and 18 has 9 2s. Voila. What else can we see here? 1 plus 4 is 5, and 5 and a 3 is 8. That's not a multiple of, this is a multiple of 3. This is a multiple of 3, and that's a multiple of 3. See, 8 plus 7 is 15, 5 plus 1 is 6. Since the sum of the digits of 87 is divisible by 3, 87 is divisible by 3. Let's divide by 3. 8 has 2 3s, 2 3s are 6. After we take away 6 from the 8, we have a remainder of 2. 2 goes and joins the 7, becomes 27, and 27 has 9 3s. Since we divided the top by 3, we have to divide the bottom by 3. 51 has 1 3, 1 3s. After we take away 3 from the 5, we have a remainder of 2. 2 goes and joins the 1, becomes 21, and 21 has 7 3s. Is there 17? Oh, there is a 17 on the top. Let's get rid of this 17 with that 17. It's gone. Oh, there's a 29 here. There's a 29 here, and that's a 29. That makes our life easy. That is gone. We have 11 and 13, which tells me that this guy is must be multiple of either 11 or 13. Let's try 11. Or we can divide 13. Either way is fine. See, let's divide by 13. If you divide by 13, let's divide by 13. How many 13s does 14 have? How many 13s does 14 have? 14 has 1 13. After we take away 13 from the 14, after we take away 13 from the 14, after we take away 13 from the 14, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 3, becomes the 13 again. And that 13 also has 1 13. And that will take care of this 13. And now, finally, we have 11 at the bottom here, we have 11 on the top here, and those are gone. And what we are left with is 2. What we are left with is 2. That's the end of it. The question is, the million-dollar question is, the problem that we just do, the problem that we just finished, the million-dollar question is, what do we learn? What do we learn from this problem that we just finished? What do we learn? We learn that
that 51 right here, 51. Most people think 51 is a prime number. 51 is not a prime number. It's very easy to see. 51 is made up of 5 and a 1. 5 plus 1 is 6. That's the first thing you should check. Before you conclude that the number is a prime number, always check to see if it's divisible by 3 or 7 or 11. Those are the three most common mistakes people make. 3 is very easy to check. Just look at the sum of the digits. 5 plus 1 is 6. It's not a prime number. It's divisible by 3. So we learn that 51 is not a prime number. That's the first lesson we learned. 51 is not a prime number. That's the first lesson. I shouldn't put a 1 there. That's going to confuse the one hell out of us. That's the first lesson we learned. Lesson number A. 51 is not a prime number. What else did we learn? We also learned that 91 is not a prime number. Where is 91? Right here. 91 is not a prime number. Now 9 plus 1 is pretty easy. It's not as straightforward to check. It's not as straightforward to see because 9 plus 1 is 10 and 10 is not divisible by 3. So the 91 is not divisible by 3. It is not divisible by 5. So the next thing we check is 7. And it is divisible by 7. 91 is divisible by 7. We just did it. 91 is divisible by 7. 9 has 1 7. The remaining 2 goes and joins the 1 becomes 21. And 21 has 3 7s. 91 is not a prime number. So that was lesson number B. That's lesson number B. What else did we learn? We also learned that lesson number C, we learned that 87 is not a prime number. Where is 87? 87 is right here. And that's our lesson number C. A, B, C. Three numbers that most people, when they are in a hurry, they miss that they are prime numbers, which can be a very costly mistake in any of these exams that you're preparing for, whether you're preparing for GRE or GMAT or SAT or SAT or TEES or HESI. You have to be able to recognize your prime numbers. You must be able to recognize your prime numbers. Do you understand? And if you are not very good at it, then I'm going to give you one more video to watch. And the video that you're going to watch to learn your prime numbers is watch Basic Math Day 20. Instead of giving you a bits and pieces here and there, if you want to improve your math skill, if you want to make sure that you know all the basics, if you want to make sure that you have all the basics mathematical concepts at your fingertips, it is important, it is vital, it is crucial, it is essential that you watch at least the first 100 videos. I'm not asking you to watch all 200, but at least make sure that you watch the first 100 videos, 1 through 100, of which the first 10 videos, I'm telling you right now, the first 10 are very silly. They just teach you timetables. But after that, it begins to pick up the pace. Do you understand? Watch all the videos that you can find there where you think that you need help on a given topic, whatever the topic might happen to be, whether it's probability or ratio or proportion or average or prime numbers, whatever the topic happens to be, they're all there. Do you understand? Bye now.